Hello, everyone, and welcome to another exciting episode of We Shot First. We are in Season 5 of the Dawn of Defiance campaign. We are playing Book 5, The First to Strike. I like the name because, you know, we shot first. On the planet of Nazarene, they have made contact with a underground, shall we say, resistance that has been built up by their leader, Sartok. He has assured the party that at his signal, he has allies throughout the city with small arms that will rise up and cause the Empire's garrison, checkpoints, point gold, Transdotian slavers and their ship at the base, like all kinds of trouble, while leading us to survey the city and possibly start this. The Empire beat us to it. They put up a brand new checkpoint and had already started harassing, as they have been, Nazarene citizens. Smoke bombs, they come running out of the smoke, and the party, by the skin of their teeth, I mean, this was a battle of the eight, no it wasn't, plus two cover bonus, three squishy stormtroopers. It was sad. It's a sad day in GMing, it's a sad day in writing. Not happy. A lot of GMs would go, no, meh. This episode is airing in the new year, January 5th, 2023. And last year, we had a heart-to-heart about how we play Star Wars and how we DM, GM, how we rules lawyer, and over our approach. And we feel that we've been sort of losing sight of the fun aspect and crunching a little too hard on the rules. That doesn't mean we're going to abandon rules as raw, but it does mean we might do a little bit more of go in the moment and less fact-checking every second as we crawl along. So if we start going off kilter as these guys level and the rules become more advanced, we ask your forgiveness. We do appreciate comments on YouTube, in our Discord, anywhere you can to remind us, going, hey, I think you missed something. I mean, hey, that did actually get, no, I don't think Doug's consistent nagging of me back in the day when he was just a fan got him a spot on the cast. But we need someone new. You know, we need somebody new watching us along. We do have a bunch of people that have surfaced. Shout out to Andy Jenkins, who comments regularly on YouTube, and we always appreciate his comments as he follows along, whether he's liking what's going on or not, appreciating laughing along, or just, you know, face-palming what we're doing. Always appreciated. And we want to hear from you as well. Gentlemen, the battle seems to be over. And on comms, you hear Spectra announcing her ETA.
I have eyes on you, boys. I'll be 30 seconds out.
And with that, suddenly, V-wings go screaming overhead, dropping mines and making blaster fire runs on larger buildings, strafing the streets. One of the buildings besides you explodes, sending chunks of rubble everywhere. The buildings groan around you and look ready to collapse. What do you do? And when I say explode, I say this building explodes. The back half of the building that Leth and Rahal are in explodes.
Master, are you all right?
What comes back to you over the comms is garbled, because there's a lot of interference, but you do get between him and Rahal, you do get a thumbs up. They say that they're trapped on the other side of the building. They'll be able to get out, but not onto the street. We'll have to circle all the way back around, or get Merrick to fly them over. But they tell you to get out of here because we're in the open and now they're doing airstrikes.
Understood. We should all take cover inside one of the buildings.
Now, right below us, you see the two doors?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep.
Right next to TLXS, that door is open from, you know, from the building shuttering and whatnot. And you see from a set of stairs leading down into this little bit more sturdy looking basement bunker, you see a stairwell that's reinforced on the lip. So even the building came down. It looks like this is actually like reinforced bunker, and it's popped open, and a voice calls to you.
Over here, quickly. You'll be safe here.
A frail, older Nazarene female waves you to follow her into the lower level about what seems to be the bunker entrance. With a loud crack, other buildings begin to slide into the street and threaten to bury you. Well, that sounds
like... It's probably a trap, but we should head in.
That's fine. Yeah, we need to get out of here.
I will take... Point? I'm sorry, go ahead, Aiden.
Oh, I was going to say better possible danger than definite danger. But yeah, if you take point, I'll take second. Spectre, you got the flank?
Yep.
All right.
As we step in, I'll use a standard action to turn on my expansion module for the square behind me. At any given, you know, at that point, it's behind me. When it matters, it'll be south.
Okay. Can I have you guys roll for initiative, please?
I rolled a 75. I don't know why you'd have any questions about that.
No, that's illegal. You aren't allowed to do that. Huh. Not unless I'm allowed to roll a 76.
You are.
Okay.
See, the Jedi Council's spoken again, Jeff. I just don't understand what.
Spectra. Can you give 22. Me a straight answer? 20. Thank you. Nice having a straight answer. Oh,
look at us both get 32s.
I don't see your roll on here, TLX. Oh, there it is. There it is.
It is 30. On there.
Well, true to form, Skeel Aiden did get 32.15 to your measly 32.12. So, still Aiden for the win on the condition track, as per usual.
Don't you want to re-roll that, Aiden?
Okay.
No.
Now, I will hold this at round zero. I just didn't want to explain something and then suddenly go, oh, and then everyone, you know. You guys.
I have one other question, if I could.
Sure, yeah.
Which is, I will let you, let me know when... If this is the beginning of a new encounter, technically my grand leader temporary hit points are gone, but I can re-up it for the next encounter. I would like to do that now, assuming that it's going to last.
Oh, yeah,
for
yeah. No,
the
no,
encounter.
There was that sort of, we won, dust, 30 yep. seconds out, she jogs up and we're just kind of emerging from cover. And then suddenly out of nowhere, the V-wings and just start bombing and like, oh, shit, you know. The V-Wing being sort of a break and encounter. Now this old lady's going, come with me, have an apple. Yeah, sure. So yeah, just so there's no discrepancy.
So everybody can have 9 temporary hit points for the encounter ahead.
Yes. He gives you the assuring shoulder pat. Really weird with the droid because just the wrist moves. You get 9 and you get 9. So on your sheets, have they added that now? I know they've adjusted the sheets.
They do, but it doesn't work very well. I think people should just overcharge their regular pool.
As long as you guys have it straight.
Although, actually, you just charge it, track it separately, and how many of your
you have your current and you have your total. And if you take your current
and then you
up,
have a bonus,
right? Then you have your current up, right? Or a bonus. Now you guys have taken wounds. You're not at full.
I am. I haven't taken any wounds.
Somebody.
Nope, I am.
None of them.
The doctor
Leth took damage from Skeel when he moved object on him.
And okay, no Spectre.
That's the only damage.
Spectre should be at full because she did have rest and missed that session. So Spectre, you should be at full. Mm-hmm. And you're saying you boys have taken no damage from the last encounter?
You weren't able to hit us.
See, now that sounds not nice, Doug. Which we're supposed to be.
I'm saying this at the beginning of a new adventure where you're just about to take us in. I should keep my mouth shut, is what I should do.
Let's ask Ryan. Not here. Matt, still not here. Oh, did I mention this is a bottle episode of just 3 players? Okay, come into my basement, Doug. All right.
I have some candy.
I have an oil bath downstairs. That's where you get a droid.
Oh. Everything's coming up Millhouse. Hey, Doug, you just head down there. All right. All right, guys.
I have a holocron for you.
It's a little bit too lucky, right?
Yeah.
Not exactly a common item. Can you, ladies and gentlemen? Oh, I changed the map and...
Actually, TL, let me take point. You can cover Spectra better than I can.
Understood. Just try to stay within 25 or 30 feet of me, if possible.
I'm not running too far off. And then I'll enter the door and start heading down the stairs. Still got my blaster out. And then I'll actually draw my Shoto saber. Keep it unlit, but keep it in my left hand just in case.
Okay.
And I'll suggest that Spectra occupy the square immediately behind me, as that is the one that has an extra shield rating of 15 protection. Doesn't, you can move out if you need to, but you could stay there. That way, if anything did fall on us, you'd at least have that.
Bothan's in the back. Good. That sounds very racist to me.
Many Bothans saved the with the SR-15 for this.
So, heading down the stairs, feel free to take a step into the room, into my trap. I mean, down the stairs. You follow her down into the lower level of what seems to be a church or an old meeting house. With a loud crack, again, you can hear buildings shifting above you. What do you do?
I will have both my rifle and my pistol drawn.
Okay. You guys look a little beat up, but does anyone appear injured? Like, no, I know you've taken no injuries, but it doesn't, right?
No.
Okay.
Forget if I mentioned Grand Leader. Everybody gets the 9 bonus hit points, and I think that puts us all above max.
Yep.
Yeah.
Come. Let me look at you. Are you all right? It was very brave of you taking on those terrible, terrible machines. You remember Sartek said the Nazarene people are rather afraid of those things. You guys
where
are like,
is
how
she? And can I make it? Where is she? And
she's everywhere. She's in the, I am not putting her on the board.
You guys not, we have not seen. Well, no. Okay. So we saw her at the door briefly, and then we went inside, and now we're just hearing a voice in the room. I'd like to make a perception check to see where that noise is coming from in that voice.
Okay.
I'll respond to her. Yeah, I think we're all right. And I mean, that's kind of what we're here to do, is to help deal with the Empire and help you get back on your feet.
Yes.
And an 18.
Word travels quickly. She steps out of the shadows, but you had already pegged her position. It seemed that she just kind of wanted to get down the stair and out of the way and into like a secure part of the bunker. She's standing near a post right here. Okay, she appears to be unarmed and is asking you guys to come forth so she can have a look at you, and seems to be for this great big Wookiee-sized creature, she seems to have the mannerisms of a classic venerable female from any species. She shakes a bit, you know, she squints at you in the darkness. She has a charismatic way of wisely speaking. Does not seem to be a threat with any weapons. And just takes a moment to see for herself if you guys are okay or uninjured. TLXS gets a very quick look over and a shake. Like, unless you're sparking out of a panel, not much she can do for you. But she does, you know, take the time to look at Skeel. She takes a long time to study Spectra, probably because you're covered from head to toe. Can't really see if there's like wounds on you kind of thing. Thank goodness you're not harmed, she says. And then she notices your Shoto. Are you and she just sort of closes her eyes and lets you sense her. She doesn't say, are you the Jedi or whatever? She just sort of does a faint little ping like, one of us.
No, ping back with a 32.
32. Yes! I'm one of us! And I told somebody who's going to bed, so I went, yell, whoops. It's that damn aerial conehead, man. You just got too much of a transmission.
But no, I mean, it was more of just trying to get the roll out, but I will ping back.
Technically, with a 32, that would mean you'd have such control. Such a tiny little queef comes out of our Jedi, it's fine. See, is that... such control.
Queef, thank you very much.
Well, that's what she did at you. I just figured you were mirroring the effect to let her know that... all right. Pretty sure kids still listen to this. Anyway.
Yep.
But yes, you're right.
Drawing attention to my actions and words just makes it worse, guys. I'm just saying. Good. Good. I am Yurka Ego. But you can call me Yurka. You will be safe here for the time being. This structure, and she just starts nattering on and starts walking, giving you its history that really only makes sense to them. And yeah, it was some sort of meeting place. It was reinforced. It's older than the buildings up top. You really get the sense that everything in here is scarce, but it looks like a place that could be supplied easy or cleaned out easily. There's some very simple supplies here as well. There's like some blankets and some water and stuff. So obviously she's been, helping. You know what I mean? But it's not like there's weapons or a whole bunch of soldiers that could the Imperials could go, aha! Nothing down here, but a lady in her little homeless shelter kind of thing, right? They're pretty clever.
Yeah.
Can I have a perception check all around, please? And is there anything anybody wants to do whilst, listening to Grandma natter on?
I'll sheath my pistol, I'll draw my other saber. Again, keeping them both unlit, but just in hand.
Mm-hmm.
So.
14 on my perception.
28. Yeah.
19 for me.
Okay. 14, 19, 28. 14. TLX says, there is an exit. Possibly a secret, tunnel on the far side. It's about 10 feet, two squares, 10 feet wide, and it goes off in a straight sort of keel, maybe slightly elevated, so eventually it'll probably hit surface, or maybe it just goes to another building. 19 Skeel, you notice that she just seems completely oblivious to, now that you guys are here and safe. And obviously she might have been told who you are, because she's like, hey, strangers, come down here or whatever. And points at the water and starts, reminiscing about the building and its meaning. Seems somewhat oblivious to a faint clanking noise that starts coming down the tunnel. Spectra.
Yep.
You know this clanking noise. You know the sound of four-legged crab droids. Because they are scouts. Knowledge tech from Samantha for Spectra for seeing it. Because this is something else. I was like, everybody just like throw in and you guys were on comms. But if you see or think of something, you do have that advantage to kind of go first if you had said a role. Do you have knowledge tech? Galactic lore? Nope, you just camp out. Oh, there you go. There it is.
22?
22. Yes, an LM-432 crab droid scout is something that you have dealt with often in the war. They, I'll just pull up a little picture here. It's show and tell time. Nee, 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 nee. Show to players.
It's a mini version of what Boba Fett fought in Mandalorian. what the Mando fought in that for now.
There's better pictures, but a lot of them were just end up being websites. So I'm like, this is like in a video game, but that kind of thing.
It's like a baby version of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you recognize the noise that's clanking down. Skeel, things that clank are obviously droids. Something's coming. And very soon, even with the 14, TLXS will be aware when they get closer. But there are ways down there.
We have incoming, nodding in the direction that I hear the noise. Mm-hmm. These things are pretty nasty. They're agile and they're really tough. They're going to do damage from afar, and don't let them get too close to you, because if they get a hold of you, it's going to hurt.
All right.
Understood. Ma'am, get behind us. And I'll gesture for the old lady to walk past me. And I will light up.
How high is the ceiling?
12 feet.
Excellent. I'd like to be near the ceiling.
Okay.
Move my shield diagonally down.
I can never remember. Is it one square or three squares? So 1 meter, 3 meter each square. 3 meters square?
5 feet, so.
It's not 5 feet. It's all mirrors. This game is all metric.
It's unfortunately in both. So each square is 5 feet, but so it's a meter and a half, as they say in the game.
Really? They don't state it as 3 meters? Because I would rather go with 5 feet. It's easier. Okay. In that case, we can basically say that there's three squares. Like I said, 12 foot, but 15. Like, I'll give it to you. So we can say your character is two squares off the ground at the ceiling. You know what I mean? I'm not going to hum and haw about, you know. He's squeezing. Because you could just fly flat or whatever. Like, he pulled yourself in half. Like, the legs and the pelvis are straight down, but he's, like, folded straight over. So, great to be a droid these days. Haha, take that, architect, right? Okay, with a moment to prepare. Spectra, you talked about what's incoming.
Mm-hmm.
What about moving or preparing yourself?
So I'm going to put myself under TLX.
Okay.
Because of the shield, and I've still got my rifle out.
Now, the shield, unfortunately, will be way up in the air behind him.
Oh.
I don't think he can, like, it has to be.
I have to use a standard action to move it, so I will try
to. But you can't project it like so many squares away, right? Even down, so.
It is always an adjacent square, so what I may do is be the square above her once I get to that spot and put it underneath me, but.
Still not going to work.
So, my idea is that everything's a 5 foot square.
Yeah.
And so, not only are there 8 squares around me, there are the set of squares beneath me, which are now beneath
me. She's the black dice. You're the gray dice. You are nowhere near her, no matter which way. You know what I'm saying? Like,
when you say nowhere near her, I'm one square off. So I do recognize that I have to spend a standard action to move my shield expansion module to the square under me, and then I need to drop back down potentially.
Okay, but when you have it adjacent, you can't hinge it. Like, it's in front of you, beside you, flat under your feet. It doesn't, like, swing down like a door. Like, you can't have it in front of you, but then slide down off your toes. Unless you just know something about this tech I don't. That just seems...
So, the square... I can protect one square adjacent to me.
Okay. Okay.
When the point comes up...
That's fine, because... the projector, I guess, like, right, thinking three-dimensionally. I'm thinking, like, flat spaces, so you gotta be on the ground. But, yeah, that's fine. As long as you hover in the middle, like, not at the ceiling level. Yeah?
Okay. I'll do that.
For now. Like I said, we'll look into this. It's kind of interests me, but, yeah, I don't see why not at the moment.
I figured that's what you were going with. That's why I said it, so.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, he's too far away because he's up at the ceiling, but we can come back to that, yeah. Sorry, we're trying to set up... This is his shield generator is a big bonus, and it's like setting a precedent like that just loosely. It's like, nah, I do want to put the brakes on that. Anyway, so... Under the droid on your shoulders soon enough. And Skeel isn't moving, he's just drawing, and she's out in the open. And she's
I'll step up a little bit.
Okay.
But I want her getting behind us, behind a pillar if possible.
Okie dokie smokey.
Cause old fragile lady. I'm not letting her fight. I mean, if she really wants to fight, she can, but I
Wouldn't you love, is this one of those moments where, like, she says, oh, hell no, not in my, goes over a table and pulls back a blanket and there's a huge E-web gun. And no, that's not happening. We have a lovely friend.
I was thinking more force powers, but also fair. I think, although it would be way funnier if she just had an E-web under a table.
For emergencies. No.
Granny's got a gun.
Granny, it's cool enough that Granny's force sensitive and some kind of ancient tradition, and we're, you know, we're everywhere. Soon to be hunted and purged, but that's another story. So with these dudes coming down the hallway. At 24. Round one. Okay. Now, there, I really don't want to go on about there is a surprise round. There isn't a surprise round. They're down this thing. You guys are alert. You know, we're in wartime. You hear them coming. They come stomping on down. And you guys have a moment to, you know, flavor, or in this case, do cool moves and stuff. Get yourself all ready. Here they come, right? At the top of official round one, it is Skeel. You can hear them.
All right.
Do you have any kind of dark vision? Like, there's no light down here at all. There's, like, ambient light spilling from...
That? I actually need to look that up. I don't remember. I don't think so.
There is light down here. Four corners, but not in the actual corners. They're like adjacent off the pillar. See these here, these pings?
Yeah.
These are like lights and torches and stuff. So it's enough to fill the center of the room with shadow and the sides of the room illuminated. So you guys, you're not going to walk into a, you're not going to trip on the floor. You're not going to walk, you know what I mean? Like the whole room is dimly lit to shadowy in the corner.
Okay.
But the tunnel that you can see exposed does not get much light beyond a square or whatever.
Right.
You do see the two beady little glowing droid crab eyes sort of pitching left and pitching right, coming closer as the legs right rather quickly. What do you want to do? TLX, get ready on deck.
Yeah, so I will rush up six squares behind the northwestmost pillar. Mm-hmm. So that I have cover to the entrance as a move action, and then standard action, I'm going to ready an action to use force grip on the first droid that enters my line of sight.
Forgot to say, 13 with some half square all around, kind of making it almost 14 squares width and breadth of this room. They came down the right side stairs just south of the center. There are four columns holding up the ceiling in the center of the room, spaced equally from each other. So the center of the room itself is bare, but you know what I'm saying? Like you're, what do you call it? Symmetrical, right? Skeel is gone to the northwest top left one, which the tunnel entrance is not in the center of the west wall. It's elevated up north a little bit, puts them in a prime position to see and have cover. Anything else, Skeel? You're good?
Nope. That's a move in a standard.
Okay. Sorry, I just realized I hadn't described the room to the audience, so.
Always happens on my term.
You go first. And then I remember.
That's true. That's true.
I'm not rehashing your actions in a cooler way. I'm just like, this is what happens.
No. This is something that I addressed long ago. It always seems like it's on my turn, but that is fair. I always go first. But yes, I'm done.
Do you actually have training and initiative on your character? It's like one of the few...
Yes. Okay. So Sarians get it naturally, but if you already have it trained, you actually get it as a skill focus. So I have it focused, and I can re-roll it if I want to.
Oh, okay.
It's some of the races have specific skills tied to them due to, you know, in canon how they kind of act.
I just
re-roll for it. So
I just, I know it's a bad habit, but it's just like between three shows, it just everything just suddenly goes out to the next one, into the last one. You know, so
no, hey, it's okay. I always like talking.
Okay. I would like to fly over to being above the Netherin woman.
Okay.
And I moved Spectre, but you know what I meant. The shield is now below me. Was I able to get that done in the last round as well? In the square beneath me?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Then I'd like to be that one square above her so that she's getting that protection.
Okay.
And then I will say,
ma'am, you should get out of here immediately. It is too dangerous.
Okay.
Do I see the, can I see them? I can see it on the map, but can my character now, see?
Perception with... and perception in this is free under certain circumstances. So even holding your last 14, like they're close enough now. Can you see them on the actual map there that I've got?
Yeah.
Right. So,
and I've got 60 feet of dark vision. So
yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like you pretty much have one now that you've moved and have easy line of sight. You see these things marching down the hall, though I seem to have shifted them into a wall for some reason. That's weird. Come on, boys. Where are you? Oh, I had them, what do you call it? I had them on the GM layer and it messed it up. Okay, sorry. So you see them. Here they come. Dun, 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 yep. Right?
I would like to shoot at the lead one with rapid shot.
Okay.
And that's going to miss probably with a 14. Is it within maybe a force point? I might be willing to force point that.
Yeah. Would you like to spend a force point? We burn them all the time.
5, springing that up to a 19.
That is a hit, sir.
Sweet. 30 points of damage, which hopefully is also a condition track.
It is.
And then I would like to use my swift action to draw fire.
I am the droid you're looking for.
And make a good persuasion check of an 18 against their will to attack me and protect everybody else in the room.
Okay. And on their turn, you will know if that is effective, which brings us to Spectra.
Okay, so I'm going to move over to the southwest pillar.
Okay, so crossing position from the back over, yep.
Okay, and my rifle's already out, so I just want to prepare to shoot the first droid I see enter the room.
Okay, now with your current vision...
Mm-hmm.
Right, because of the shadow, right? The shadow, like, because they have lights on them, you have a target. I would give them concealment, cover kind of thing. Now, okay. you don't have enough actions left to aim, but if you wanted to get a shot off now, best of luck, or unless you want to wait till the whites of their eyes kind of thing, because you yourself said, don't let them get close. So, if you want to just have a go with the shooting, right? Not to mention the droid's lighting them up. Like, you're seeing sparks, it's hitting armor. You know, poo, 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 follow the trail of droid fire, right?
I can give it a shot without aiming.
Okay. Would you like to spend a force point?
I guess.
You guess? You know what? You know what stats.
Wait, is that including the bonus to attack from point blank shot?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, we pretty much have that hardwired in all the characters now because like no one ever steps out of point blank. Like nothing's out of 20 squares.
So far.
Right. Yeah, that's fair.
Yes, that hits. And 23?
23 damage.
Okay. Youch. And now here comes the droids. Na-na-na-na. Clanking out of the darkness. These things with 8 square movement, as she warned you, come fast. 2, 3, 4, 5. Hello.
Right into grab range.
We're still moving.
Did we resolve her attack? Did her attack do damage? Oh, I'm sorry.
23, yeah. Bad. Fourth point gain sucked up, and DM's happy. Just burn those 4 points. And...
picked the wrong day to stop sniffing glue on the session.
This is what we get for pausing the recording and then going off on a tangent to save the audience, and we can't remember what we were talking about, Doug.
So sorry.
That's okay. You've given me the time to look up my perception roll. Because you know, what can we see, right? Biggest GM mistake is they just come out and go for the first guy. It's like, well, what do we see? You know, did we hear us? Do we see? Oh, look, there's a flying robot saying, come at me, bro. Well, guess we see you, you know. What else do we see? Well, you know, well, defense 12. So it comes out 5, right? 6, 7, 8. No, that's not going to work. 8.
I interrupted Aiden stopping them as they came into the room, though.
Did you have an action ready?
I had a ready to action to force grip them once they entered the room.
Basically, since I've cleared, like, my ass is still in the hall, or in the arch, but the front of me is here, this is where you want it?
Yeah.
Okay, go.
All right.
So now you're changing your initiative to 24 to go with them, right?
Yes.
Okay.
That is a 29. Ah, oh, it's so close. What the? Oh, actually, it doesn't matter. Final is 25. So if this beats the target's fortitude defense, they take 6 die 6 and can only take a swift action.
Hit me.
I got 29. Go ahead and call it out. So 19.
Do you get extra for going over 5 and 10? And
do you get extra
So 17. You beat me by 10.
Oh, no, sorry. That's only for force stun.
Okay, just check.
Most force powers is trying to hit flat DCs, so 15, 20, and 25 for force grip. And since I hit 25, it's 6 die 6 points of damage instead of 2 die 6 or 4 die 6.
Okay, so you do 19. Okay, so you start crushing this thing like a can, and the servos start jittering or whatever, and you slow it. But it keeps coming. Now, it turns into such a dilapidated crush, it's stuck. And it starts doing that machine wiggle. Flavoring a swift action, right? Like it keeps coming, then it's like, it's dragging at nothing, right? Now, they all have the same initiative. So the guy behind it, like they're all coming down the hall together. 5, 6, 7. I'm not going to count him as terrain because technically he's friendly for free. And as long as he can take a single action, I'm just not going to count him as terrain just yet. Not to get down. So 6, 7, 8. But I can't stop on a friendly. So I'm going to go 9, 10, 11. Anyway, so he comes through, around, just, you know, like they don't care about each other. One stops and jitters, the other crawls, goes up on the curb kind of sideways, two wheels driving kind of thing, crawls over it, comes down around the column and stops between the columns, but does not get into a flank in between the two of you. Double move to get there, so it does not attack, but it looks like, you know, it's got the pincers out and it's coming for you guys.
Right.
It does seem to have its attention on Buddy up top. But I couldn't stop, like, as much as I'd like just to stop and fire, I still think these things would, like, try to get this close. You know what I mean? Like, I'll use my friend as cover and shoot over his shoulder. And these are scout cat crab droids. They're not that, you know. Anyway, 5, 10, 15. Oh, shit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. Again, the other one crawls past Buddy and then starts heading south to get clear. And these guys are all piled up in a little three pack in between, clear of each other, but in between the two columns and the back wall. And that is now Spectra's turn at 22.
Okay. The one that's like pretty much right in front of me? Like in between me and the column?
Yep.
Okay, I want to aim and shoot.
All right. Pew, pew, pew.
I'm hitting the button. 21.
Is
22
it?
Damage.
Okay. This is the fresh guy. Don't worry. Lots of me left. But that does also just meet his condition. And you see sparks flying. Oh, happy day. You know, because you know. Minus one is coming. And that's how battles are won. By inflicting buffs or debuffs early on in the battle, right? Which brings us to round two. TLXS. Woman. The woman.
Yeah, that was going to ask.
Okay. So you want me to run out to the street where everything's collapsing and no, right? But she does go 5, 10, 15, and like takes cover behind a back column and is eyeballing the stairs in case she has to make a run for it. But running out in the street where, you know, everything's falling apart and getting bombed, there's nowhere to go. Round two. TLXS is now at the top. Oh, look at that.
That's right, because it moved.
Yes.
I will take a shot at the one right in front of me that is being... Actually, you've already got it stuck down to a swift action.
The back one, I have to a swift action. These two up front are fully
relatively fresh. Did you hit... Is this the one you targeted? Or the south one? You hit the south one?
I hit the south one, yeah.
Here.
Okay.
We'll give him a purple. Right?
Thank you.
And then, I will now mark them with your colors. So when I was like, oh, okay. That make
I
better?
Will target the south one as well for my shot.
Okay.
And I will rapid shot.
Sorry, when you say south one, Sam, you mean this guy or this guy?
The one you already have marked yellow.
Okay.
Roll to 29.
So close. Yeah.
And I do 32 points of damage to him.
Okay.
Oh. Wait.
Never mind. I'm fixing something. I'm not doing all the math. Just ignore the man behind the curtain. Shoot shit.
Bang, bang.
Do not count. Doug just loves like, what are you doing? I'm drawing attention, Doug.
Bang, bang. All good.
Okay.
I wanted to make sure I got the same one that
ping.
She hit. So.
Yeah, you're hitting this guy. Right?
Yep.
So there you go. Both are shooting at him.
Comboing.
We haven't done this in a while. Like, I used to mark up, just didn't like the minis, they don't show up much. I'm like, look, red dots are all bad guys, but like, oh yeah, we have the basic colors going. This is my target.
I will then float up. I will move one square up so that I am hugging the ceiling, hopefully out of reach, and then I will do another draw fire to make them come for me. Come get me if you can.
Okay.
And I rolled a 12 on my persuasion check.
Okay. How long does that last? Just a single round? Do you have to rip it?
Single round. I have to, I have, like, I burnt a swift action this round to enable it, and it will last until the beginning
now,
of my
round.
See, now,
if you were lower, they would have, but I pretty much burned all my movement just to get clear of everybody. You know what I mean? Like, they're all kind of scrambling towards you, but it's like, the guy who was, like, way in the back didn't even see you. Like it's like at the end of the tunnel, it's like, maybe he didn't know.
So anyway. Hopefully they've all seen me now.
Yes. And with your dominating 12... Against our willpower of 12.
You already said it right.
I heard you.
Was it like the fourth point?
No,
okay.
I would have probably.
So is that everything from TL?
Yeah, I'm done. Thank you.
Okay. Skeel. All
right. So I will continue maintaining force grip on the red dotted droid. That is a 30.
Squash.
So that will be another 6 die 6. Well, that's a lot of ones. 12 points of damage to him.
I just realized I had the purple dot on the wrong one. Okay. You crush him like a tin can, and it just, the center falls to the floor and the legs collapse up.
That's good teamwork.
With 8 points left doing 12, you destroy it. And being a droid, it is destroyed. Teamwork. Jedi just kicking ass, taking names. Go team.
I did the first damage.
I just see you up there like smacking your fanny going, woohoo, boys.
I've done damage every round, I'll have okay. You know.
Hey, protecting
civilians. And spent a force point to do it.
protecting civilians. I love how he goes the first thing with white hair like Leth, right? Oh, old lady, I will protect you. It's like Dr. Leth, right?
That's totally true.
That's the first thing with white hair. Okay.
She looks like Dr. Leth to me.
Yeah,
I mean, meatbags. Come on.
I mean, he knows it's another life form, but and this is the first Nazarene you've seen with hair. You know, it just. I mean, this guy's. So anyway.
That's my turn.
Okay. Sure enough, these two droids open fire on TLXS. And with their twin blasters that works as a heavy blaster rifle, which I'm taking as, like I said, it's like two regular blasters really adjacent that fire simultaneously and you get the effect of a heavy blaster rifle. No, I'm not making this up. It says it right in front of me. And I did confer off the air. So, pew 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 from these two dudes. And I'm just making sure that they don't have any kind of other proficiency they can throw in on this. No, not with the shooting. But as Spectra warned, they are far more dangerous, like meleeing with us, than firing at us. So far, our tactics of keeping them at bay are working very well. Miss. Applause. Shooting at you guys, or should I say, sorry, shooting at one guy, because yes, they take interest in the droid. Top one shoots at you with a 12. Second one shoots you with a 22.
Those are two misses.
Two misses. Do we have force points? Lately, things have been given force points, even destiny points. And that was something else that was called out. I had a fan going, what the hell? Bat Mook with destiny points? I'm like, first of all, we were personally trained by Django. Thank you very much. And yeah, what can you throw at an 8th level character but bad guys that have the odd destiny point? It's like Draco's open floodgates, right?
Those troopers were tough, man. They were tough. It was a great fight.
Still got the scars, man.
Man. I'm sorry, 22, no?
Unless you'd like to spend a force point.
I don't have any at this time. Spectra.
Aim and shoot at the one I was shooting before.
Okay. This thing just getting closer at you like Terminator on the beach. Throw shells at it.
15 to hit.
Would you like to use a force point? No, natural one is always a miss.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
No, I'm good.
Okay. Would you like to move? This thing is getting closer.
Yeah, I'll back up.
Yeah.
Towards the other pillar.
Okay. 2, 4. Happy there, or you want to move over, Grandma? Take cover.
There, it works.
Okay. They starts backing up. Granny shuffles, does this awesome, like, you know, tumble action roll over to the other. The white wig comes off. Over to the other north pillar to get out of the way of combat, like, just so that she is also, like, not in your way. Bringing us to round 3. And TLXS, the only guy with 32 in the initiative anymore. Congrats. What do you want to do?
Second first, probably very similar to the first first. First thing I'm going to do is shoot at the same one we've been shooting at in the south.
Mm-hmm.
With a rapid shot.
Please. Crit.
I might have critted with a natural 20, giving me a 31.
What do you mean might have? So 20's always it. Always crit.
And for 60 points of damage.
Kaboom. It just blows. Always. It's like having droid parts, knowing sense of places. It's like, sorry, primitive brother. Right? It blows it to shit. It's like a guy shooting a monkey, like a primate. I feel, akin and yet not that worried.
You are clearly inferior models. You should be recycled.
And I'll draw fire.
Oh, I'm liking this new attitude. First the hate starts for the droids, but then we can just shift it to meatbags sooner or later. I'm liking where this is going, and Doug. Happy New Year.
I get a 26 on my persuasion check, and then I'm going to float back two squares to make it come further to get me.
Okay. Which and brings us to Skeel.
Nope.
Okay.
I will attempt to pick it up with move object. And that is a 19 for a 36. Now, if I had used any light side powers due to my lightsaber crystal, I would have actually gotten all of those back. But because I haven't, I get nothing. But because I beat a DC 35, I can move up to colossal size objects and do 10 die 6 points of damage to this thing as I slam it into this back wall.
I don't see a size on my description here. Like, it's obviously large, but 4 is at least large. But yeah, sounds good.
I mean, I think our ship is colossal size, or maybe frigate size.
Okay, so where am I going flying again?
Just having him fly 10 feet to the west and slightly south.
That's a nice solid bunker wall. Just scatter his friend.
For 41 points of damage.
Okay. This thing hits the wall, crumples, and comes down. And then it's its turn. There's that moment hesitation, and then it uses a move action to get up from, like, just to kind of, the bottom of the barrel kind of hits the ground and the legs kind of pop up high because of the force. And then it pushes on the legs and the servos, and it's damaged, like it's struggling to move kind of thing. But as a move action, it stands and it goes to lift a leg like it's going to come at you. And it just stops like it's pointing, and I shoot you with my gun because I'm shoot you with my twin blast. I just got to shoot you. I believe TLXS has aggro on me unless I'm directly affected by a closer character. So yeah, I do shoot you. I just wanted to check that with Doug, but he's nodding like sadly yes. Poor Doug lays all this tactical groundwork, and everybody just ignores it. 16.
That is a miss.
That is a miss. Maybe I should call up people to donate,
No,
your crab droid could
probably still attack me. I don't unless I have cover from. Yeah.
No, I thought that something like me, right? if I was attacked.
Nope.
So if I was outside of TLXS's 6 square, the radius,
which I might be 3-dimensionally, because
you
said that was 6
actually
when you're
are. Yeah, because I'm 6 squares away and you're 1 square
up.
Hot news. I would say, but either way, it misses.
Well, yeah, 1 square. Yeah.
Not a huge deal.
Okay, yeah. So now that we're all happy deciding for me again, but I did want to check. Just teasing you. Shoots at you, misses. Bringing us to Spectra, because the other droids are dead.
Yeah. Same as before, aim and shoot.
Well, that tends to be a solid tactic. I agree with that.
21 to hit and 32 damage.
Well, now, after suffering 41 and then 32.
Just put it out of its misery?
No, but it does take serious damage. It, judging on like how many shots and how much damage it took to take down the other ones, like this thing is definitely on its last shall we say, legs? Yeah, I didn't even like that one either. Round four, TLXS. Grandma cowers.
Well, maybe I'll get the kill shot because it's still standing. Does it? I will move forward to make sure that I'm in.
How many squares? Just tell me the square movement. You move four forward.
One, two, three, four squares forward.
West, okay.
As long as I am still within six squares of Spectra, I'm hoping, on that diagonal, because it's only five from her.
Five, and then we add, this is not something you get into hypotheses. It's like, okay, yet. It's five, and then I was up one, and that becomes six. Like, we're not getting into, you know.
Yep, and I will rapid shot the one that's left.
Would you like to use a force point? 17 doesn't cut it.
No. But I will draw fire again.
What?
You should probably surrender.
Okay. What happened to Angry Droid? You're inferior. You need to be put down. Now he's not even
going to... get a 17 on my persuasion check.
I don't know. This is wishy-washy with the character. I think you need some maintenance, dude. You're
so trying to get a force point out of me on this side.
You were all so aggressive. Die, robots. Hey, you know, even 3PO had a glitchy moment.
He's on his last leg. We've killed 2/3 of them.
Yeah, and see, that's what I shouldn't say anymore. Because then you guys are like, he's not a threat.
I feel that whether you said anything or not.
You take the kill shot. I won't take the kill shot. It's a force point. I mean, I don't want to burn a force point. Anyway, you do what you do. And which brings us to Skeel. He's happy to crush things all day long, I'm sure.
I mean, it's what I did during the Clone Wars.
It's what I do.
It's what I do. So I'm going to use my second instance of move object to try and pick it up and slam it into the ground. So this is a 29.
It gets up and you're like, ooh, yep, and down. Quish. Yep.
Not again. But that is only 6 points of damage. So 14.
Pick it up, flip it over, crush it. Could you actually do that? I was just going for flavor, but it's like, could you actually? No, it's kind of a sort of a one movement, right? Up and drop.
Well, you can move it up to 6 squares, so theoretically you could flip it around.
Yeah,
that one's on you.
Up 3. Ceiling down. Anyway, it's fine.
Crab legs on the menu, boys.
Now, didn't Joe talk about mixing fantasy quotes with Star Wars? You know what I mean?
don't cross the streams.
That was good, though. Not force point worth good, but good. Spectra! a moment's hesitation? Perception? Wow, she's role-playing that moment's hesitation. That's committed.
23.
That's committed to the role.
Man, if she had pulled camera, she was clearly percepting.
You watch the LED eye lights fade on the last droid, and then use your keen wolf-like hearing through the mask to hear nothing but empty hollow cave sounds. It was a scout patrol of 3. Usually it's a single. If you got 3, that's probably not a lot more down that hall. Should be good. Battle's over. Sorry. We're clean.
Okay, I think we're good for now then. Tell the others. Mm-hmm.
I will fly over to the west of the room and stand watch up the tunnel while the Jedi continues any conversations that need to be had.
Okay. In less than an hour, one battle, 3 characters. Wouldn't it be funny if we played the rest of the season like this? You know, what if those comms kept fizzing? What if those guys are on their own for several battles and you guys are on your own and we spend the entire book trying to find one each other? Like one of those torn war stories, you know, where like
Ooh. A droid is trying to get back to his master and kicking ass along the way. And Dr. Leth forgot about you 5 minutes ago and we'll spend the next 3 hours not really worrying about you. And we will bring this, you know, that sounds good to me. And this old Nazarene just like just gloms onto Skeel, you know. You are powerful in the old ways. You know, grabbing him by the shoulders, eyes wide, shaking him like, you're the man, you're the man, you're the man, you're the man. Holy shit, holy shit, holy shit, holy shit.
The sabers. I'll deactivate them so I don't accidentally chop off her hand.
Can you? I am old, but, you know, my it starts going on about life force transference, and like, obviously she has vital transfer, and it wants you to train her. If you could train my people to fight like that, we are few and far between, but the advantage that you stay, honorary Nazarene, she starts, I don't know, she got like her dead husband's leather something and her, you know, puts it on your head, you know, just tries to make you look more Nazarene, goes on about inducting you. I think you're about to join a cult, but hey, how would you like a 70-year-old Padawan? Don't answer that. You
know, honestly, probably not the worst thing in the world. They're going to be more productive than Rahal.
And we will see you all next time. Imagine all the problems that would come with like a 70, like an elderly, vulnerable Padawan, right? Come, young Padawan. I'll come at my own pace, damn you, master. Like, just having a crotchety Padawan. Like, I think we could roll with this. Let's. She has a name, man. I'm just saying, like, she's a third level non-heroic, 24 hit point, has vital transfer and use the force plus 5, which means she's like twice as powerful as Rahal. I think this is a new Padawan. go for Team Nazarene. I'm liking this a lot.
Heck yeah.
Good night, everybody.
Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks now. What the emperor say on a 66 now. But the force is strong and I feel it still. Gonna make it out to the heat. Gonna reason with the senators, try to make it better now. But somewhere out there's gotta be free. I guess we'll head to Alderaan now. Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks now. I've been rocking it since Order 66 now. The force is strong and I feel it still. Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks now. What the emperor say, Order 66 now. But the force is strong and I feel it still. We should fight a war for peace. Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks now. Resurrect the Jedi, bring the emperor down to his knees. The Sith mean nothing to me. I should strike them all down now. For the Sith who killed the little Padawan, he is my enemy.
Is he coming? 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 Is he coming back?
Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks, and I'm gonna keep on going till the galaxy is fixed now. Cause the force is strong and I feel it still. Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks now. I've been rocking it since Order 66 now. The force is strong and I feel it still. Ooh, I'm a rebel just for kicks now. What the emperor say, Order 66 now. But the force is strong and I feel it still. Cause the force is strong and I feel it still.